her bone is not in her. She's a diamond under. Wanna lay it down, I'll try my heart.
Hi guys, so today I'm going to show you this makeup look right here. Today is September 22nd, so today is officially the first day of fall. This makes me so excited. From this point on, I'm hoping the leaves will change quickly and everything will be beautiful and taste like pumpkin spice. Yeah. So this is the makeup look I'm going to show you. So if you would like to learn how to make it or recreate it yourself, just keep watching this video. So first, to start off this look, I'm using my NYX Shine Killer Primer, and I'm going to be applying that directly on my T-zone as well as the other areas of my face. Your love is like a soldier, loyal till you die. Now I'm using a wet beauty blender and using my Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation in the shade Fair Beige. I'm just going to be applying this all over my face. Now I'm going in with the Naked Skin Concealer by Urban Decay, and I'm just going to put this on the unders of my eyes, throughout my chin, and whatnot. Alright, now that we are all concealed, I'm going to go in with a damp beauty blender and my setting powder. It's the Maybelline Master by Face Studio, and it's just a translucent powder, and I'm just going to put it under my eyes to start the baking process. I'm just letting the under eyes bake. So next I'm going to be setting the rest of the face with a big fluffy brush and my Fit Me powder in the shade 100, which I'm pretty sure is just translucent. So nights like this lead to love like us. You light the spark in my bonfire. For just a little bit of contour, I'm going in with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit in the shade Light to Medium. And I'm just going to be taking a big fluffy brush and going across my cheekbones. Alright guys, so now that we have contoured, I'm going to go back in with that big fluffy brush and kind of blend it out a little bit more. Then we are going to cut the contour with a foundation stick by Maybelline, and I'm just going to put this below my cheekbone so that we can get a nice clean cut. Now that the under eyes were able to set and bake, I'm just going to take my big fluffy brush again, and I'm just going to swoop under my under eyes just to get the excess powder out. Alright guys, so now that the full face is finished, I'm going to move on to my brows and I will be right back. Eyebrows are on. If you're wondering what I used the Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in the shade Taupe, with the little brush that it comes with, and also a concealer by Maybelline. This is the Master Conceal with a flat brush, so I can tighten up the edges a little bit more for that clean, perfect look. And to finish off the rest of the face, I'm using the Benefit High Beam Highlighter, and I'm just going to put that across my cheekbone and on the bridge of my nose and on my Cupid's bow. And then lastly, I'm using the Makeup Geek blush in the shade EXO.
Don't you think that it's boring how people talk? Making smart with the words again.
Alright guys, so to start off with this makeup look, I'm going in with my Morphe 35O palette, and I'm just going to pick a few neutral shades from the palette, mostly over here in the lighter area so we can start a transition crease.
And I am only as young as the minute is full of it, getting pumped up on the little bright things out.
Okay, so now that we have a nice transition crease going on, I'm going to go straight in with a ridiculously bright color. I'm going to be using this bright orange color, and I'm going to be putting that on my lid and gradually putting it in my crease to blend out with my transition. To do that, I'm just going in with a flat brush, dipping into the product and going at it. Oh my God. And with that same orange, I'm going in with the same product, but with a big fluffy brush so we can start to blend it into our crease. To define the crease a little bit more, I'm going in with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette, and I'm using the shade Railgar, which is a more deeper orange color than we use in my Morphe palette, and I'm going to put that in my crease as well. Alright, so now that I've did to the other eye, we are going to smoke out the bottom lash. So I'm just going back in with my Morphe palette, and I'm going to use this kind of goldy, yellowy type of shade. And I'm just going to put that on my waterline to smoke it out and make it look more elegant. Alright guys, so next I'm going to go in with my Morphe palette, the 35O Shimmer. And I know I dropped it, so RIP to three of the shades that crumbled on me. But we are going to make do. I'm going to go in with this like almost really dark gold color. And I'm just going to put that on the middle of my lid just to give some sparkle. There it goes again. Alright.
When my head's filling up fast with the wicked games up in flames, how can the fuck?
And lastly, for the shadow portion, I'm going in with this NYX pressed eyeshadow in the color Girl Talk, and I'm just going to put it in my inner corner just to kind of lighten it up a bit.
Then we're all in line for the throne.
Lastly, I'm moving on to the Maybelline Master Drama eye pencil, and I'm just going to put this on my waterline.
It's a new iPhone showing people how little we care. We're so happy.
Now just applying some mascara.
Smiling out of fear. Let's go down to the tennis court and talk it up like yeah. And talk it up like yeah. And talk it up like yeah. Let's go down to the tennis court and talk it up like yeah.
Alright guys, and for the lip, I'm using the Maybelline Stick Lipstick in the shade Touch of Spice, just for a little bit of spice. And lastly, I'm going to lock it all in with my NYX Matte Finish Spray. And this is the look. All Alright guys, so that was it for the video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to follow me on my social media. It will be right there. And I will see you guys next week with a brand new video. Bye guys.